हेलो स्टूडेंट, इन टुडे सेशन वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट द नेक्स्ट पार्ट ऑफ आवर यूनिट नंबर 4, दैट इज सॉलिड स्टेट वेल्डिंग. इन सॉलिड स्टेट वेल्डिंग अप टिल नाउ वी हैव डिस्कस अबाउट द कोल्ड प्रेशर वेल्डिंग, देन एक्सप्लोजिव वेल्डिंग. ओके, नाउ इन टुडे सेशन वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट द व्हाट इज मीन बाय द अल्ट्रासोनिक वेल्डिंग. ओके, सो सी हियर, here is the introduction of the ultrasonic welding. The ultrasonic welding is an industrial technique whereby frequency ultrasonic acoustic vibration locally applied to the workpiece being held together under a pressure to create the solid state weld. Means in ultrasonic welding, the high frequency vibrations are produced, and due to this high frequency vibration, the local heating will be done, and due to this heat the material get joined together. Okay, so why use of the ultrasonic welding? What is the need to use the ultrasonic welding, that we will discuss here. What is the first need? That ultrasonic assembly use the ultrasonic vibratory energy which transmitted through the parts to the metal and bond thermoplastic material and joining a thin sheet gauge metal and light weld materials. Means ultrasonic welding, in the ultrasonic welding, due to the high frequency vibrations the local friction will be done, and due to this local friction the material will join together, the heat is produced, and due to this heat material get joined together. So this technique is a fast, efficient, non-contaminating and require no consumption. In this method is fast because the time for which we will pass the ultrasonic vibration is in a few seconds. Okay, then efficient. Why efficient? Because it does not require a large amount of, or it does not require the large machines or others. That's why it is efficient, non-contaminating. The heat produced due to the ultrasonic welding is at only small area. It will be not at large as compared to the arc welding. So the heat affected zone in this case is also less, and due to the less heat affected zone this method is non-contaminating and require non-consumable. In this method, or in ultrasonic welding method, we does not require use of filler material. That's why it is, or the tool that we are using for ultrasonic welding is not consumable. So these are the reason, that's why we using a ultrasonic welding. The third one is, in ultrasonic welding there are no connecting bolts, nails, soldering material or adhesive necessary to bind the material together. In ultrasonic welding we does not require connective bolts. In other, or in arc welding, they requires a connecting bolts for a fixture purposes. Here they does not require a connective bolt. Nails, soldering material. What is mean by soldering material? Soldering material means a filler material is not required in this case, or adhesive necessary. Means in some cases we need to apply some adhesive or a flux, but in a case of ultrasonic welding we does not require adhesive. That's why we use some advantages of the ultrasonic welding. The principle of the ultrasonic welding. What is the main principle of the ultrasonic welding that we will discuss here? In ultrasonic welding, the frictional heat is produced by the ultrasonic waves. The frictional heat is produced by the ultrasonic waves, and the force is used for joining process. Means in a ultrasonic welding, high frequency ultrasonic waves produce a friction, and due to this friction heat is generated. The ultrasonic wave, what is the frequency of this ultrasonic wave? It is up in a range of 15 to 60 kilohertz, that amount or that frequency range of the ultrasonic waves are used for ultrasonic welding are transferred to the material under a pressure. Means this amount of high frequency ultrasonic waves are transferred to the material under a pressure. The welding time is lower than 3 seconds. As we discussed that this process is fast process, because the welding time for this process is lower than 3 seconds, the welding can be produced with or without application of the external heat. Means in some cases we can apply the heat or in some cases we cannot be apply the heat for the ultrasonic purpose. Why we need to apply the heat? If the thickness of the material is high, then preheating is necessary. That's why we can say that some heat is necessary for the ultrasonic welding. But if the thickness of the material is less, then in case we does not require the application of the external heat. See here, this diagram will show the principle of the ultrasonic wave. Here is converter, this is sonotrode, this is vibrating tools, this is a ultrasonic vibrator, vibrations, weld seam means along this line weld, and these are the workpiece. This is a roller welding, ultrasonic roller welding, and this is the ultrasonic spot welding. So in ultrasonic spot welding, if we see here is converter. What is the use of the converter? This converter converts the electric energy into the mechanical energy, that is vibrations. The electric energy will convert into the mechanical vibrations, okay, and these vibrations are produced given to the vibrating tools. This tool or the vibration that produced by the converter is given to this tool. That's why it is called as the vibrating tool. And the force is applied on this tool. The force is applied on the tool, and due to these vibrations, the local friction will be done. And due to this local friction, the heat is generated, and due to this heat, material get welded. So this is the schematic diagram of the ultrasonic welding machines. So here is pneumatic piston. To this pneumatic piston, the electric supply is provided. There is transducer, there is converter, booster, sonotrode, horns. These are the equipments, or this is the equipment used for ultrasonic welding. The joints formed with the ultrasonic welding. Which type of the joint we can form by using a ultrasonic welding? See here, two parallel wires. Means this type of the wire we can produce the two wires with bridging. Means these are the so then wire on sheet, wire stand on sheet, sheet on sheet, T profile on a sheet, and T profile on a pipe. So these types of the joint we can produce by using a ultrasonic weld. Here is two parallel wires, means two wires can be joined by the ultrasonic welding. Then sheet with two wires, then sheet with one wire, or like this. Means this type of the joint we can produce by using a ultrasonic welding. So this is a spot welding for aircraft wings. So these are the some example of the ultrasonic welding. Here is welding Gulf Stream thermoplastic rubber. So what are the advantages of this process? What are the advantages of this ultrasonic welding process is that heat affected zone is minimized. As the heat is produced in a heat produced is localized, that's why the heat required or heat affected zone is small here, because the heat is produced is localized heat, and this heat will not affect the large area of the workpiece. That's why here is a heat affected zone is small. Then very thin materials can be welded. As the amount of heat produced in an ultrasonic welding is due to the vibration or due to the localized friction, And as this heat is, amount of this heat is depend on the time for which we are transmitting these ultrasonic waves. As we transmit the ultrasonic waves for large time, then amount of heat generated will be high. If we transmit these ultrasonic waves for small time, then this time will be a small. Okay, this time will be means this heat will, the amount of heat that produce will be as less. That's why depend on a time we can change, we can produce a different temperature. So if we reduce the time, then temperature will get reduced, and that's why very thin material can be welded together. Okay, so this is the advantage of this process. Surface deformation is minimum, as in a case of arc welding or other types of the welding, the deformation of the surface will be done because of the large heat affected zone due to the high pressure and other things. But in a case of ultrasonic welding, the surface deformation is minimum. Welding of the glass is also possible. To weld the glass, this can be also achieved by this ultrasonic welding. So this is one most important advantages of this ultrasonic welding. No defect due to the gases or arc or filler material. The defect as we discussed what are the different types of the defects in the welding process. So different defects will be produced due to the use of shielded or due to use of the noble gases or due to the arc or due to the use of the filler material. But in this ultrasonic welding process, there is no use of the gases, no use of the arc, no filler material is required. That's why this no defect will be produced in a case of ultrasonic welding. The equipment is simple and moderate skill is enough. As we discussed, there is only one simple equipments are required, and as the equipment is a simple, and if we consider the case of arc welding or a laser welding or other types of the welding, the highly skilled labor is required or highly skilled person will be required. But in a case of ultrasonic welding, moderate skill worker is enough for to do the welding process. So moderate skill worker can easily do the this ultrasonic welding. This similar material can be joined. As it is a solid state welding process, so the different or dissimilar metal can be easily joined by using a ultrasonic welding. So what are the disadvantages of this process? Restrict to join the thin material. Actually here the word is wrong, that is restriction to join the thick material, because the large thickness or the thickness of the material is the high, then this can be not joined by the this ultrasonic welding, because the as we required that the vibrations should be high, as the heat generated is also depend on the vibrations or frequency. And if we produce the high frequency ultrasonic waves, then it will be affects on the workpiece also, and it will also affects on the machine also. Due to the high frequency vibrations, the workpiece get damaged. So the high thickness, the material having a large thickness cannot be joined by this process. Comparatively not economical. Why this is not economical? Because the cost of the machine is high, so that's why it is economically means its initial cost is high. The material being welded may tends to weld to tip and anvil, means the fixture that are we using or the tip of the electrode that we are using, the material will get stick to that electrode also. So these types of the problems are arrived in a ultrasonic welding. So these are the disadvantages. Then application where these are used, manufacturing of the toys means these ultrasonic welding is used to join the thermoplastic material also. That's why it is used in a joining of the, or it is in a manufacturing of the toys. Joining of electrical and electronic component, to join the electrical and electronic component, this ultrasonic welding process is used. Welding aluminium wire and the sheet, as we discussed that in this process we can join the wire with the sheet metal also, or we can join the wires together also. That's why it is used in a joining of welding of the aluminium wire and the sheet also. Mobile, sports shoes, lamination, car, etc. Okay, in mobile phones the circuits, so electronic circuits that are used joined by this welding. Sports shoes is also joined by, as thermoplastic is used, that's why it is used in this. Then laminations and cars, to manufacture different parts of the car, this ultrasonic welding are used. Packaging, medical industries and the computers. In packaging industry, or in medical industry, or in computers, this ultrasonic welding is used. Now we will see one video that will, so it will get clear idea about the ultrasonic welding.
Ultrasonic welding. Ultrasonic welding is a solid state welding process. This process does not involve the use of electrode or filler metal or generation of
arc. See here, the ultrasonic welding is a solid state welding process, and in this ultrasonic welding there is no use of the electrode, filler material and the generation of the arc. The arc will not generated in a ultrasonic welding. Okay,
arc. It is a welding process which uses ultrasonic.
See here, this is the horn of the machine and these are the two workpiece, and as this horn produces the high frequency ultrasonic waves, due to this high frequency ultrasonic waves, these vibration are given to this workpiece, and due to this vibration,
sonic vibrations to weld or join. Working principle of ultrasonic
localized
welding. The weld is produced by the application of a high frequency ultrasonic vibrational energy in the order of 20 kHz to 40 kHz. This causes,
and localized heating will be done. The amount, what is the frequency of that ultrasonic waves is here they given about the 20 kHz to 40 kHz, but in some cases it is from the 15 kHz to 60 kHz also.
Is friction and hence heat is produced.
See here, local heating will be done here.
The point of contact between two workpieces to be joined together, thus producing a metallurgical welder bond without melting the metal. Parts of ultrasonic welding machine.
Different
power supply. An normal line voltage of
The power supply. The power supply required in this case is 240 volts.
240 V is applied. Transducer or converter.
Then there is a transducer.
A converter is used to convert the high frequency
electric
signal into high frequency mechanical vibration, and it does so by using the piezoelectric effect. Booster and horn.
This is a booster.
A booster amplifies the frequency and is then supplied to the horn. Horn transmits this vibrational energy to the workpiece. Fixtures. Fixtures are the devices used to hold and
what is the use of these fixtures? The fixtures are used to clamp these workpieces together.
Clamp the two workpieces together. Working. The parts to be joined together are held in contact with each other under pressure by using the press and fixtures.
The workpiece here, workpiece is clamped between these two or in a fixture, so it will not get disturbed.
Then high frequency electric.
Once we start the electricity flowing through this, or once we start the switch, the electric current will be a flow, and due to these
signals
current,
are then converted into high frequency mechanical
converter,
vibration with the help of a converter
into the
or transducer.
Energy,
then it is fed to the booster, which amplifies the vibrational energy.
This
high frequency vibrational energy is then transferred to the workpiece to be joined together with the help of a horn. This vibrational energy at the contact between the two workpieces generates local friction and shear force and produces plastic deformation.
The friction will be local vibrations, the local friction will be done, and due to this friction, the heat will generate it.
Thus generating heat, and the two pieces are joined together at the interface metallurgically upon cooling. Hope you are enjoying our videos. Apart from these videos, we have interesting courses description below. If you vips on how to sharp, no heat is supplied, and no melting occurred, therefore heat affected zone is minimum. Very thin materials can be welded. No need for electrode and filler material. Dissimilar materials can be welded. The process can be automated. Provides goods.
Okay, so first one is the heat affected zone is minimum. We have discussed why this heat affected zone is minimum. Very thin metal can be welded. No need of the electrode and the filler material. Dissimilar material can be welded. This process can be automated, means we can automate this process and provides a good surface finish even after the welding. The surface finish that obtained is a
Surface finish after welding.
Our surface finish is good.
Disadvantages.
Then there are some.
This welding process is limited to thin malleable metals and for small welding areas. It is limited to lap joint due to fatigue load.
The first one is this welding process is limited to the thin malleable materials and for a small welding areas. This process is not for the thick material. This is only limited for the thin materials and the small areas. It is limited to the lap joint, and due to the fatigue loading, the life of the equipment is short. Due to this vibration, the life of the material will be short.
Loading. The life of the equipment is short. Tooling cost and fixture
and
is high.
Cost and the fixture is a high cost. Means the tooling cost, means the cost of the equipment is high, and the fixture cost is also high.
Application. Now it is used in electrical industry to produce delicate circuits, flash drives.
PPT also. So these are related to the ultrasonic welding process. Okay. This is all related to the ultrasonic welding process. Okay. So this is enough for today's session. That is ultrasonic welding. What we have discussed in today's session that what is the ultrasonic welding, what are the principles of the ultrasonic welding, how this welding process will be carried out, what are the different parts of the ultrasonic welding equipments, then what are the different types of the joint that can be produced by the ultrasonic welding, what are the advantages of this ultrasonic welding, what are the disadvantages of the ultrasonic welding, and what are the applications of the ultrasonic welding. Okay, so all these part, that is all this procedure of ultrasonic welding, we have discussed in a today's session. Okay, so it is enough for today's. In next lecture we will discuss the next parts of unit number 4.